The committee chaired by Nakawa West legislator Joel Senyonyi, while interfacing with officials of the National Medical Stores, led by its general manager Moses Kamabali, discovered that National Medical Stores is in the process to write off the bad debts amounting to 25.8 billion shillings of government entities that have defaulted to pay for drug supplies from the entity.
Honorable Chair, we have Ministry of Health as Minister of Health Central. We have Minister of Health for, at the time, it was for NETS, for LLINs. We have Minister of Health as the Islamic Development Bank.
How do we even get to engage? You're saying maybe Parliament should recommend this money is deducted at source or that kind of thing. Yeah. How, when you're saying you are asking finance, let's write off.
Yes.
Because you're giving up. Why do you want us to carry this burden that you're failing to carry, that you seem to be easing up easily?
Committee members protested the move to write off dates, saying the National Medical Stores have not seriously engaged the entities which have failed to pay. MPs wondered how National Medical Stores can fail to recover money from entities which are still doing business with it.
All this money, just like that, 25 billion, I think can build the 25 health centers.
But Honorable Yomgeji, I think you have made a very pertinent issue. They are continuing dealing with them. How can you write? Because you cannot write if they are not existing, but you are still dealing with them. How can you write? Appropriate this money. We pass it. All this, including taxes, for all these entities, including you. So the no minister should deceive you that because we are the same government, then why would we appropriate here? That money, we pass it to them, unless there are budget cuts in their ministry.
Public entities and other organizations owe National Medical Stores 51 billion shillings of arrears for unpaid supplies, of which 25.8 billion shillings are in bad debts. The Minister of Health is the leading data with 31.4 billion shillings.
We recommend that you don't write off any debt as of now, because we don't know what effort you have made so far, and we need to get that effort through correspondences, through, you know, meetings that you have had, where maybe someone has said, you can go to correct the data and someone tells you, I won't pay you.
National Medical Stores General Manager Moses Kamabali explained that the National Medical Stores Board recommended the write-off after the debtors refused to pay, and it also failed to trace supplying vouchers to some of the entities, like the Uganda AIDS Commission, since they phoned the date when they came to this office.
Dates written off. Is that so?
Yes.
When we are passed the money.
Is this money you're no longer interested in, or what?
It became very difficult to get it, and the board said, if you cannot get it, what? Why are you keeping it on your books?
Do you think you have done enough to get this money paid?
We at one time thought actually that with these debts being there, they would be probably, with the recommendation of this committee, Honorable Chair and Honorable Members, they would deduct it directly from the person who owes us the money, and it comes directly to NMS.
The committee chairperson, Joel Senyonyi, ruled that the National Medical Stores has no authority to write off these debts without clearance of Parliament, and asked them to avail documents detailing the engagements with the entities so that Parliament decides whether to write off or not.
We have discovered that National Medical Stores has debtors who owe it to the tune of 51 billion shillings. Now, on their own, they wanted to write off 25.8 billion shillings. We've told them no. Stop that. First of all, you don't have authority to write off these debts. You've got to come back to Parliament. These people who are meant to pay, Ministry of Health and so on and so forth, who owe billions and billions of shillings, they come here to Parliament to appropriate money for their use. So how do you then say, let's write them off? Because they're still doing business with them.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.